in first practical we have seen that how can you get the content which is written inside the file and display that content on your output screen. In the second practical I have shown you that how can you enter the content, how user can enter the content in the command prompt and how that data can be stored inside a file. Now in third practical, as you can see the aim over here, the third practical is saying to copy content of one file to another file. So let me show you something. First let me copy this content or aim and paste it inside my IDE in as a multi-line comment. So here inside multi-line comment I want to copy or write a program to copy the content of one file to another file. Now let me show you something. Let me close this. Here on my desktop there is a file named temp. We have already used this file. You can see the content of temp file over here. I have created another file, that is copy file. You can see there is nothing inside copy file right now. What I want, this content of temp file I want to copy inside this copy file, but by using program. So how can I do this? Now here we are dealing with two files, so we should keep two separate pointers for each file. So first let me write include stdio.h, then include stdlib.h, then int main. After that I'm writing return 0, right? Now what I need two file pointers, file pointer source and destination, right? And here as it is pointer I have to write star. Let me just do a semicolon, right? Now after that I need character array to hold the name of source file and target file. So character array s name, that is source file name which is having size 50, and d name, that is destination name, destination file name, and another character I need to hold the characters. I will show you why you need ch. Now what I need, first I will say source equal to, but before assigning the pointer I should get the name, right? So for that I am telling user to enter the source file name, right? So user will be able to enter by using get s. Inside get s I am using s name. Now I can write source equal to, where source is this pointer, equal to f open, it is opening the file with name s name and it is having permission read, because you know that in my temp file I am not going to write anything. So I don't need write permission, I just need read permission so that user will be able to read the data. So now I am assigning source, I am opening the file and assigning its permission read. Now I am checking if source equal to null, then after I am printing if it is true, that means some error occurs, so error, right? Now then after exit 0. So for this exit 0 I am using this library. So definition of exit 0 is being written inside this header file. Now if this is not the case, that means we have successfully opened this file. I am going to copy this content and I am going to paste that enter the destination file, right? File name, and here it will be dd. Here destination, make sure that you write the correct spellings. So let me just copy it over here. Destination f open dname. So the file dname will be opened, but now inside my dname, that is destination, I'm going to write, I'm going to copy the content from temp to copy file. So copy file will be written, so that's why I have to give permission write over here. So that is a little change. After that I'm going to check for that file also, that if it is having any error or not. So here if destination equal to null, so if I'm just copying this and pasting it over here, destination is equal to null, first of all I will just close the file, which is pointed by source, because it is no longer needed if we cannot open destination file. Then I'm going to print error and then exit. So if any of this condition is true, that means our file cannot be open and then they cannot be copied. But if the both of this condition is false, that means our program is correct and both of them file are opening correctly. So then after I'm writing while, inside while ch equal to f get c to get character for from file, which file, which is pointed by source. So the source character from source file will be copied and to this ch, and until it is not null, so until not equal to e or f, not end of the file, I am going to print. So for that I am using f put c to print. Put c is used to print something inside my file, right? So print something inside my file, I need this. So for that I am writing a ch, character should be printed to destination. So the file which is pointed by the destination. So after that, after it is successfully executed, I just need to close say source file and f close the destination file. Let me save this program, compile it and check it if it is correct or not. So there is no compilation error. I'm giving file name as temp.txt, destination file name as copy.txt. It stops executing. Now let me just check. So if I go to this desktop and see, you can see now my copy file is having the content which is similar to the text temp file, right? So you can see this content. Even if you don't want to manually open this both files, you can just write a program to show the content of a particular file, which is first practical, and to see if it is correct or not. So this is all about the third practical, to copy one file of content of one file to another file. Now we are headed to our last lecture, which will explain the fourth practical. So see you in the next class. If you have any doubt, comment below the comment section and ask me. Thank you so much.